This is a video presentation from Ahmadiyya International School, Grade 8 Computer Science, and the unit that I'll be covering today is data storage. As you all know, we have covered units such as data input devices, where we have seen devices such as keyboard, scanner, etc. And we have seen devices, that is data output devices such as speaker, printer, etc. Here we will be seeing data storage devices such as DVD, RAM, okay, CD, floppy disk, etc. Coming to the next slide, here we see the classification of storage. Storage is mainly divided into two types. One is main memory and then secondary memory. Main memory is also called as primary storage, whereas secondary memory is also called as backing storage device. Okay, under main memory we have two types, ROM and RAM. ROM stands for read-only memory and RAM stands for random access memory. We will be discussing each one in detail in the coming slides. Secondary memory is divided into three types, magnetic, optical and flash memory. Under magnetic we have tape and disk. Under tape we have devices such as cassette tapes, and under disk we have devices such as floppy disk, hard disk, etc. Tape, in other words, it is also called as serial access storage device, whereas disk it is also known as direct access storage device. Under optical, optical means we make use of laser in order to read and write the contents. Here the devices which come under optical are CD, DVD, Blu-ray disc, DVD, RAM, etc. The third classification is flash memory. Under this we have pen drives, SSD, which stands for solid state drive. Okay. Now coming to the main memory. In main memory we have two types. One is random access memory, the other one is read-only memory. Now coming to the ROM. ROM stands for read-only memory. What happens in case of ROM is, during the manufacturing stage, okay, the manufacturer loads a program called as BIOS, which tells the computer, okay, where the operating system is, okay. So the contents written to it cannot be erased. So this one is also known as non-volatile memory. So the contents written to it cannot be erased even though the power is off. Nowadays we have different types of ROM, that is PROM, which stands for programmable read-only memory, and EPROM, which stands for erasable programmable read-only memory, and EEPROM, electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. These have different applications, such as PROM is used in CD players, EPROM is used in television, and EEPROM is used in smartphones. Coming to random access memory. What happens in case of random access memory is, okay, once we write the contents to it, once the power is off, the contents in it will get erased. So this one is also known as volatile memory. What it holds? It holds both the working data as well as running programs, but temporarily. Okay, there is classification of RAM. There are two types of RAM. One is dynamic RAM and the static RAM. In the next slide, we will see the differences between static RAM and dynamic RAM. In case of dynamic RAM is made up of capacitors. The property of a capacitor is it cannot hold charges for long time. That is, if you write a content to the DRAM, after some time, after some milliseconds, the content in it will get erased. Whereas in case of static RAM is made up of a component called as flip-flops. So unless you erase the contents or you switch off the computer, the contents in it will be present. Okay, let's see the differences. Okay, DRAM is made up of tiny capacitors, whereas SRAM is made up of flip-flops. Okay, DRAM is an inexpensive technology, whereas SRAM is an expensive technology. DRAM is slower than SRAM, whereas SRAM is faster. DRAM uses less power, whereas SRAM uses more power. DRAM uses less heat, whereas SRAM uses more heat. Now the applications or where it is used, DRAM is used in main memory, whereas SRAM is used for cache memory. Okay, these are some of the differences. The main difference is DRAM is constructed by making use of capacitors, whereas SRAM is constructed by making use of flip-flops. Coming to the next slide, that is buffer memory. What happens in case of a buffer memory is, there are certain devices such as scanners or printers, okay, where there are Suppose there are two computers giving print requests, all these print requests will be stored in the buffer memory. Once the print has been completed, the contents in the buffer will get erased. Okay, so it will hold the data unless the job is done. Okay, now coming to the difference between ROM and RAM. Okay, ROM holds the data permanently, whereas RAM holds the data temporarily. ROM is also called as non-volatile and RAM is called as volatile. Okay, ROM is an electronic chip. It can hold data in the form of MBs in the computer, whereas in RAM it can hold data up to GBs. Okay, what does ROM contain? ROM contains startup instructions, whereas RAM contains working data and running programs temporarily. Now coming to the secondary memory, though there is no main memory, what happens in some cases is we need additional storage. So we can make use of secondary memory storage devices such as DVD RAMs, we can make use of CDs, you can make a floppy disk. Okay, all these devices come under secondary memory. Okay, the three classification of secondary memory is disk, or magnetic disk, optical and flash memory. Under magnetic disk, okay, what is it made up of? Magnetic disk is made up of thin metal of a plastic coating with the magnetic material. Wherever you want to write the contents will be written in the form of zeros and ones, and the contents are written in the form of magnetized spots. Okay, here the magnetic disk is divided into different concentric tracks, okay, and further divided into different sectors. Okay. Now coming to the first device under magnetic disk, that is a hard disk drive. Okay, hard disk drive is made up of a single spindle, okay, and there are several disks which are placed one above the other, okay, and it comes with an aluminium casing, okay, with the magnetic coating on it. Nowadays what happens is every computer comes with the hard disk drive inbuilt in it. Okay, the features of a hard disk drive is it has its own read or write drive, okay, which makes the read or write faster. The advantages of a hard disk drive is it's a very reliable backing storage device. Okay, data can be retrieved very fast. Okay, and it also stores fairly large amount of data. What can be the disadvantage of a hard disk drive? In case of a hard disk crash, the data in it will be lost. So we need to take up the backup regularly. That is one of the disadvantages in case of a hard disk drive. Next, coming to the optical disk. As I mentioned earlier, optical disk means we make use of laser to write the contents. Usually the laser used is red laser or blue laser. Okay, the devices which come under optical disk are CD, DVDs, Blu-ray disk, etc. Okay, these devices usually consist of single or more spiral tracks. Okay, what are the features of it? This is made up of a thin metal with a protective polymer coating on it. Okay, what is used for writing the contents? A laser is used for writing the contents into the disk. Okay, the first device that comes under the optical device is called as a compact disk. Okay, how much data can be stored in a compact disk? We can store data up to 700 MB. Okay, the contents written in it cannot be rewritten. That means once you write a data into it, it cannot be rewritten. But nowadays we have different types of CDs in which we can rewrite the contents all over again. What can be the advantage? The very good advantage of using a compact disk is it has fairly large capacity to store data. The other one is it is very portable and it is very lightweight, and it is a cheap in cost. Where is it used? Since it is cheap and it is used, it can store up to 700 MB of data. It can be used in libraries, it can be used for storing encyclopedias, it can be used for storing maps. Okay, then there are different types of ROM, CDs. These are CD-ROM, CD-R and CD-RW. CD-ROM stands for CD read-only memory, CD-R stands for CD recordable, and CD-RW stands for compact disk rewritable. Okay, I will be explaining each one in detail. CD-ROM means it is an optical media disk, okay, that can be read, okay, but it cannot be written or it cannot be erased. Okay, CD-R means, or CD recordable means, here you can record the contents to it once and rewrite or read as many number of times. Okay, you can write it once, but you can record as many or read as many number of times as you want. CDRW means compact disc rewritable. Here what happens is you can write the contents to it, you can read the contents, you can erase the contents all over again and then write the contents to it again. So as many number of times you can rewrite the contents to a CDRW. Okay, next the device that comes under optical is digital versatile disc, the short form is DVD. What is the capacity of a DVD? DVD stores up to 4.7 GB of data. Okay, that is about 6 CDs. So if CD is storing 700, it can store more than six times of CD, that is around 4.7 GB of data. Okay, it is made up of two layers. Okay, so it is also known as dual layer disc. Okay, what can be the applications of a DVD? DVD, since it is having higher storage, it can be used for storing films, it can be used for storing softwares, it can be used for storing encyclopedias. Okay, what is the type of laser that is used to write the contents to it? It uses only red laser to write the contents or to read the contents. As I explained in case of CD, there are three types of CD. Here also there are three types: DVD-ROM, DVD-R and DVD rewritable. Okay, that means once you write the contents to it, it cannot be erased. Okay, that is in case of a DVD recordable. And DVD rewritable means you can erase the contents fully and then you can write the contents all over again. Okay, next comes in the version of DVD, we have one more type called as DVD RAM. What happens here in case of DVD RAM is it is made up of several concentric tracks. Okay, that means it, and the other speciality of a DVD RAM is you can write and read the contents at the same time. Okay, and it makes use of red laser to read and write the data. Now the main application and the most important use of this DVD RAM is, okay, in case of satellite TVs, what you can do is you can record the live matches in the instance. Okay, suppose you want to pause a live match, you can pause it, but the recording will be going on in case of a DVD RAM. Next slide is about Blu-ray disc. What is Blu-ray disc? It is a type of optical disc, that means it makes use of a laser, but the difference here is, since the name itself tells Blu-ray disc, it makes use of a blue color laser to write the contents. Okay, it makes use of a blue color laser. What can be the storage capacity of a Blu-ray disc? It can be around 100 GB of data. And the other difference is it is a double-sided Blu-ray disc. Okay, and the main difference between all the other devices is it makes use of a inbuilt encryption technology. It has a inbuilt encryption technology so that the data can be stored or it can be kept securely or safely. Okay, now the summary, next slide is about the summary of the different devices that we have seen so far. Okay, permanent memory. Okay, which is permanent? ROM can be permanent, CDRW can be permanent, DVD RAM can be permanent, hard disk drive and solid state drive. Temporary means once the power goes off, the contents are lost. So only device which comes under this is RAM. Okay, which is the one which is having a single spiral track? Single spiral track means only one spiral track is running throughout the device. Only one device comes under it, that is CDRW. The devices which has concentric tracks are DVD, RAM and hard disk drive. Okay, then there are some devices or some storage devices which makes use of millions of transistors in order to store the data. The ones which come under this are ROM, RAM and solid state drive. Okay, then coming to the laser, which are the ones which make use of red laser and which makes use of blue laser? Red laser is made used in CDRW and DVD RAM, whereas blue laser is used in Blu-ray disc. Okay, now coming to the flash memory. We have seen magnetic disc, we have seen optical, now we will see the flash memory. Okay, the next classification is flash memory. In flash memory, we have this flash memory is also called as non-volatile memory, that is EEPROM. Why is it called as EEPROM? Because we make use of a sudden charge of electricity in order to remove the contents. Okay, so writing the contents to it or removing the contents from a flash memory is comparatively faster as compared to the other devices, and it is made up of millions of transistors. Where is it used? Flash memory is used mainly in memory cards, it can be used in smartphones, or it can be used in pen drives. The other difference is, okay, as compared to the optical and other devices, here it has no moving parts, okay, and it is not very sensitive. That means if you do any damage to it also, for it can manage the damage up to some extent, okay. It is lightweight and it has a high data transfer rate. The next slide is about the solid state drive. In this slide you can see the outer side or the exterior of a solid state drive, and the other picture shows you the interior of a solid state drive. Okay, then what is it made up of? It is made up of several flash memory chips. Okay, several flash memory chips are clubbed together to form a solid state drive. Okay, nowadays what we are going to do is we are using SSD instead of HDD. Why we are making use of SSD instead of HDD is, okay, SSD has no moving parts in it, whereas HDD has some moving parts in it. Okay, the other one is SSD is lightweight as compared to HDD. Okay, and it is portable and it is mostly used nowadays for storing the data. Here also, in case of solid state drive, they have inbuilt encryptions. These slides clearly show you the different flash memories or the different chips that are used in the making of the solid state drive. So this comes to the end of this unit. Okay, we have covered different types of storage devices. We have seen different types such as primary memory and secondary storage. Under primary memory we have seen RAM and ROM, and under secondary memory we have seen magnetic, optical and flash memory. Okay, so you have to go through the notes. We will be submitting, or we will be giving you the notes as well as the worksheets. Okay, the worksheet should be done and it should be submitted on time. Okay, go through the textbooks, go through the videos as well. This is a slideshow, so you can go through the slideshows as much as you want. Okay, thanks.